Wearing books plus legitimate daughter plus imperial uncle plus group pet plus relaxed Shen Qingshuang was awakened by a whip from the guard of the fourth prince of Qi, Gu Jinhao. But after scolding the female supporting character in the book for playing a good hand of cards poorly, she woke up and became her. Is that okay with you? Having taken over the position of the legitimate daughter of General Dingyan, she forcefully took over the blame of the original owner. To save my life, the first thing I did was to tear apart the true face of the White Lotus Lady and offer to treat Gu Jinhao's mother. The illness has been cured, and she has been targeted by the Black Face God. She doesn't eat hard or soft, doesn't eat oil or salt, and only lives a life of prosperity. No matter how well Gu Jinhao tries to please her, she remains unmoved. Until one day, he learned that the little uncle who had been hiding from the world for a long time had actually stayed overnight in the Shen mansion, and even said that he would get used to staying a few more times. Gu Jinhao. What do you like about Uncle Xiao Huang? Shen Qingshuang counted his fingers and said, he is handsome, gentle, dedicated, wise, and elegant. He has a higher generation than you. Keywords of the novel. Xianyu's legitimate daughter wants to be rotten. The prince knocks on the door night and night without a pop-dot-up window. Xianyu's legitimate daughter wants to be rotten. The prince knocks on the door night and night. Download the complete text. Xianyu's legitimate daughter wants to be rotten. The prince knocks on the door night and night. Latest chapters to read. Chapter 1. Your Highness, she recruited. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Chapter 1. Your Highness, she recruited. A small black room filled with torture tools, with a few half-lit candles flickering and casting shadows on the wall, making people feel frightened. On the ground lay an unconscious girl, about 15 or 16 years old. As for appearance, regardless of the few strands of long hair hanging on the forehead, and ignoring the dust on the face, it is still quite delicate. In front of the girl was a chair, on which sat a young man dressed in black with an angry expression, about 18 or 19 years old. His eyes were deep and he couldn't tell what he was thinking. The only thing he could be certain of was whether he was angry or very angry, which made people shiver. Your Highness, what should she do if she faints? A guard-like young man held a whip in his hand and looked puzzled. I originally intended to force a confession through severe punishment, but as soon as the whip was raised, the girl was frightened and knocked out, leaving him unsure of what to do. At least she's also the daughter of the general's mansion, so I can't help but be scared. The man known as His Highness squeezed out a word. Strike. Hey. Since the master wants to fight, then let's fight. Anyway, if something goes wrong during the fight, someone will take responsibility. The guard, emboldened, walked towards the girl. As soon as he lifted his whip, he heard her muttering something and immediately rejoiced. Your Highness, she called. Qin Yun, go listen to me. His Highness said a few words calmly, his eyes sinister. If that girl were awake, she would probably be scared unconscious again. Qin Yun immediately bent down, listened attentively, and then fell into contemplation. What did you say? Hearing the question, Qin Yun cleared his throat and said, boiled fish, braised fish in brown sauce, pickled Chinese cabbage fish, sweet and sour fillet. His Highness looked at him like a fool and said, Qin Yun, are you playing with me? No, 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 Your Highness, that's all she said. Qin Yun felt very aggrieved, he was just conveying it. Your Highness, may I hear from you again? Listen attentively. In the following are, braised pork ribs, sweet and sour pork ribs, steamed pork ribs, and glutinous rice chicken ribs. After repeating with fear and fear, His Highness slammed the teacup in his hand in front of Qin Yun and shouted angrily, Qin Yun, you really think I have a good temper? No, 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 Your Highness, you misunderstood. I will use punishment now, use punishment. If this whip goes down, this delicate little girl will suffer a lot, but Qin Yun has no choice. Who wants her to provoke this fierce god without any trouble? Pop. With a flick of the whip, the clothes on the girl's arm cracked open and blood oozed out. At the same time, with a mournful, "Ah," she woke up. Tears streamed down my face as I cried and cursed, "Which bastard dares to hit my aunt? I curse your ancestors for 18 generations." Qin Yun's hand, which was about to swing the second whip, stopped there. Since it was his ancestor and they were all dead, wouldn't it be easy to die? "Why did you hit me? Believe it or not, I'll sue you. I'll sue you for everything. I'll compensate you for everything." The woman struggled to stand up with her arms in her arms, it really hurt. I only heard a cold voice. "Accuse? Where are you going to accuse? You have infiltrated this prince's mansion with ulterior motives, which is already a capital offense that cannot be escaped. Now I don't know if the sky and earth are thick enough to speak out loud. Qin Yun, keep fighting. Just now, one whip has cursed her ancestors for 18 generations. Another whip may not be enough for her to curse." Qin Yun hesitated but saw the woman staring at them like a ghost, and couldn't help but stand straight. Her big and bright eyes blinked before suddenly clasping her fists and saying, "Hero, can you tell me where this is? Who are you? Who is he? And who am I?" End of this chapter. Chapter 2. What tricks are you playing? You are listening at novelfull.audio. Chapter 2. What tricks are you playing? Qin Yun looked at the whip in his hand and felt foolish. At the same time, covered in cold sweat, her three brothers didn't even peel him off. However, he answered honestly, "This is the fourth prince's mansion. You are Shen Qingshuang, the legitimate daughter of General Dingyan. He is His Highness the fourth prince, and I am His Highness's guard, Qin Yun. Miss Shen, if there are no other questions, I will start fighting. Please hold on." Shen Qingshuang's eyes immediately opened like copper bells. "I strangled her, did she wear a book? But scolding the female supporting character for having a beautiful family background, being used as a gun for a lifetime, playing a good hand poorly, being an idiot, and then directly wearing it on her body. Typical of you, go ahead." As the whip was about to fall, Shen Qingshuang quickly ran to the corner of the wall and shrunk, tentatively saying, "Is that Gu Jinhao?" Under the dim light, she carefully scrutinized the young man with a frosty face, gradually overlapping with the people in the original owner's memory, and many things and many people gradually became clear. Qin Yun made a silent gesture and said, "Is your highness's name taboo, something you can call directly?" "Oh, no, 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 I'm wrong. I'm wrong. Can you tell me why you hit me, hero? Being beaten always requires a reason to be beaten." Qin Yun couldn't figure it out and cleared his throat, saying, "Didn't I ask you a question and you didn't answer? Then you ask again and I'll answer well. Just answer, she must know everything without hesitation, as long as she doesn't suffer from physical pain. Shen Qingshuang, what tricks are you playing?" Gu Jinhao propped his chin, squinted his eyes, and the chill emanating from his body made Shen Qingshuang's body straighten slightly. Shen Qingshuang didn't know why the original owner liked such a black-faced god, probably because of a brain twitch. Extremely upright attitude. "No tricks, please start. Okay, first of all, why did you climb onto His Highness' bed while he was drunk?" Qin Yun's serious demeanor made Shen Qingshuang feel like she was participating in a quiz competition, but it also helped her understand the whole story. Although she changed the chip, it's important to acknowledge the original owner. "Because I used to like His Highness, but never had the chance, I believed the slander and attempted to cook ripe rice while His Highness was drunk." Gu Jinhao snorted coldly, but it was sincere. "Just why was it, before?" Qin Yun saw that he didn't speak and continued, "Secondly, who sent you here? Is your father?" Shen Qingshuang cannot implicate such a high-ranking and influential father. Shaking his head seriously, he said, "No, it's Fang Mingzhu." Upon hearing this name, Gu Jinhao was noticeably surprised and stepped forward to pinch her neck, saying, "What are you talking nonsense about?" Shen Qingshuang knew he liked Fang Mingzhu, so she wasn't surprised either. She just couldn't help but slap his hand, it was too uncomfortable. When he finally let go of his hand, she was almost out of breath and coughed several times before finally calming down. "Your Highness, you may not believe me, but I will defend my right to speak to the death. Today, Fang Mingzhu found me and asked for what she needed. She knew that I used to like your Highness, so she intoxicated you and allowed me to take advantage of the situation, thinking that if everything was done, I would be able to enter the palace. And she has a reason to break up with your Highness and make you feel guilty towards her." Qianyu carefully glanced at Gu Jinhao, but saw that his eyes were red and he tightly grasped the armrest of the chair with both hands. He gritted his teeth and said, "Mingzhu and I are in love, how could she do this? Not only do you not repent, but you also poured dirty water on her. I want to kill you." Gu Jinhao reached out and drew the sword next to her, about to stab Shen Qingshuang. She was so scared that she quickly hid behind Qianyu and said, "Help me, hero. I didn't lie. Fang Mingzhu wanted to become the emperor's consort, but she didn't want to lose the heart of his Highness. This is the usual trick of green tea and white lotus." Qin Yun's just one whip was carefully flicked and bounced. If this woman died in the palace, the Shen family wouldn't rebel. Afraid of causing trouble, he knelt down and advised, "Your Highness, calm down. She is the legitimate daughter of General Dingyan and the famous protector of the old man Shen Nanfang. She cannot be killed, absolutely not killed." Shen Qingshuang peeked out from behind Qin Yun and timidly said, "Your Highness, if you don't believe me, I'll prove it to you. Now, let's go to the Prime Minister's mansion." End of this chapter. Did Chapter 3 succeed? You are listening at novelfull.audio. Did Chapter 3 succeed? Fang Xiangfu. Fang Mingzhu sat by the window gazing at the moon, thinking about the promise made by her cousin Xufei to take her into the palace, and her face burst into laughter. "I just don't know if Shen Qingshuang has succeeded. To be fair, she is unwilling to give up on Gu Jinhao, the grand fourth prince of Qi. He is handsome, elegant, and holds a high position of power, making him a dragon among the people. Unfortunately, the dragon among people is not a dragon after all. How can I compare with the one sitting on the throne now, even if I have a deep affection for her? I had originally hoped that he could become the crown prince, and I also had a good mother in the world. However, I didn't expect that the old emperor would directly pass on the throne to the current emperor before his death, causing her to be in vain. I bet the wrong treasure, just bet again. Anyway, she has a beautiful appearance and a prestigious father. If Shen Qingshuang can succeed, she will openly break up with him and become the emperor's favored concubine. My cousin is already at the end of her life, and she won't be able to live long." As soon as she entered the palace, she had a prince in her hand. With time, her future is limitless. The maid Suedao watched her concentrate and handed her a cup of clear tea. "Miss, are you still asleep?" Fang Mingzhu regained her senses and lightly lifted her vermilion lips, saying, "Has Shen Qingshuang come?" "Not yet." Looking up at the sky again, "Did you stay overnight at the royal mansion?" Thinking of this, he snorted lightly and said, "It's a good deal for her." At this moment, the butler came to report, Miss Shen is at the door. Please come over." She stopped drinking tea, and Fang Mingzhu ran towards the mansion with her skirt in hand. Sure enough, Shen Qingshuang stood at the bottom of a nearby tree and waved at her. "Qingshuang, did you succeed?" She took her hand with anticipation in her eyes. Immediately pursed his lips and looked disgusted, "What kind of clothes are you wearing? So plain." Shen Qingshuang smiled slightly. "This dress belongs to the maid of the royal palace, so she can't wear the whipped one. Isn't that just revealing the truth? I disguised myself as a maid and entered the fourth prince's room so that I wouldn't be easily discovered." Fang Mingzhu pointed her forehead with a delicate jade and said, "I know you're smart. Isn't that your plan? If it weren't for you getting your Highness drunk, where would I have this opportunity?" Shen Qingshuang's voice slightly increased, and Fang Mingzhu thought she was excited and laughed along. What about your highness? Are you still asleep? Wake up. If he goes to sleep, who can prove what happened to me and him? Shen Qingshuang made a shy gesture, he's very angry, but the wood is already a boat. He can only admit it and said he will welcome me into the mansion. I'm afraid he'll go back and get his personal jade pendant. Fang Mingzhu took the jade pendant she was carrying and nodded, saying, it's the one he had close to him. By the way, can you lend it to me for use? Shen Qingshuang deliberately pretended not to understand and said, what do you want this for? Madam, you will soon become the emperor's consort. How much do you want then? Fang Mingzhu blushed and lightly tapped her, saying, with this jade pendant, I can openly break up. Oh, I understand. You can take it. Shen Qingshuang pursed her lips and smiled, then took her hand. Mingzhu, your highness is so handsome. Did you really give it to me? Can't you please coax me? Fang Mingzhu pinched her face and smiled, if it's not true, do you think you can achieve your wish tonight? Don't worry, I don't have that kind of heart for him. The only one who deserves my heart is the current emperor. However, Qingshuang, I have also helped you achieve your wish. In the future, you should advise your highness to help me take power in the harem. I won't forget you. Shen Qingshuang fully agreed that the matter had already been completed, and she soon stayed. After praising her a few words, she quickly ran away. End of this chapter. Chapter 4. You can't pay back my king's affection. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Chapter 4. You can't pay back my king's affection. Looking at the joyful back of Fang Mingzhu as she left, Gu Jinhao's heart cooled. In his ears, there was still their promise of living and dying together, sharing joy with his son, holding his hand, and growing old together with his son, which was also under this tree. He had a bitter corner of his mouth and jumped down from the tree, disappearing into the darkness. Qin Yun had already brought Shen Qingshuang back to the royal mansion, but she still feels guilty and dares not run away. Hero, did your highness and I have any success in that? She wanted to confirm again before the black face god returned. Qin Yun was also honest and gave her a glance. When I went in to find his highness, you just took off his clothes. How much did you take off? Qin Yun said, it's almost gone. Shen Qingshuang awkwardly smiled and held her hand on her forehead, saying, what about myself? You're fine, still combing your hair. Shen Qingshuang was overjoyed. It seems that paying attention to appearance is a good habit and should be maintained in the future. At this moment, her gratitude to Qin Yun was like a flowing river, and as she held his hand, she couldn't help but thank him, thank you very much, hero. I will remember your great kindness and repay you generously. Qin Yun glanced at her again and said, shouldn't you blame me for ruining your good deed? Damn it, that's not a good thing. No wonder, thank you for protecting my innocence. Qin Yun. Dot. It's clearly this woman who wants to ruin his highness's innocence. Unfortunately, we didn't succeed. Shen Qingshuang was drinking tea and fanning, feeling very comfortable. Just as he hummed a song, Gu Jinhao came back with a cold body. She immediately jumped off the chair and stood on the side with her head down. Your highness, I didn't lie to you, did I? Can you let me go home? His tone was soft and his eyes were sorrowful, striving to carry on the pity to the end. Gu Jinhao suddenly looked up, her red eyes startled her and she quickly lowered her head again. You haven't paid the price for what I did to you. Being whipped and not paying the price yet. What is the cost? But in the end, nothing happened. Your Highness, you haven't suffered any losses. Just treat me as owing you one favor, can't I repay you in the future? You can't afford the favor of this king. Gu Jinhao squeezed out this sentence from between his teeth, his fist clenched tightly, as if it could explode with just one sentence. So what are you going to do? It's not me who caused your disappointment in love. To some extent, you should thank me for helping you see the true face of your white moonlight. How could you repay your kindness like this? Before he could finish speaking, Gu Jinhao stood up with a loud, cannibalistic look in his eyes. Shen Qingshuang dared not speak anymore and jumped behind Qin Yun, pleading with two eyes, "Hero, help, help, hero." Qin Yun. Dot. Thinking of the power behind this woman, Gu Jinhao slowly relaxed his hand and said coldly, "Qin Yun, go to General Dingin's mansion now and tell Shen Nanfang what his daughter has done to this king. Let him come to the palace to lead the people." Upon hearing this, Shen Qingshuang knelt down and tugged at Gu Jinhao's hem, tears streaming down her face. "Your Highness, please don't let my father come. He's an old man and wants face. He always values the glory of his family and will kill me. I'm still young, and I don't want to die," she said. Gu Jinhao disdainfully pulled out the corner of his clothes, his eyes extremely cold, and he didn't want to look at her at all. "Qin Yun, don't go yet." Seeing the evil fire spreading on himself, Qin Yun shuddered and respectfully said, "Yes, Your Highness." Shen Qingshuang quickly got up and pulled Qin Yun, "Hero, wait a moment." "I dare not wait." Qin Yun quietly pointed to the person on the chair, also scared to death. Shen Qingshuang was ruthless and stomped her foot, "Your Highness, I have cured your mother's illness. Let's settle this matter. What do you think?" Gu Jinhao's mother was the favored concubine of the late emperor, Lady Xian. Since the late emperor's death a year ago, she has been sick. The imperial physician has seen her many times and prescribed many medicines, but she has not been doing well. There is also a downward trend, which is a heart disease of Gu Jinhao. It was precisely because he was afraid of seeing his mother's sickly appearance that he dared not go to Shouan Palace frequently. Suddenly hearing Shen Qingshuang say this, Gu Jinhao seemed to have misunderstood and looked at her with suspicion. She cleared her throat and said, "I'm not joking. I can treat Princess Xian's illness." Before he spoke, she confidently said, "If it's not cured, I'll give you my life. If it's cured, all our grudges will be written off. Do you want to do it?" End of this chapter. Chapter 5, But They Dare Not Rule. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Chapter 5, But They Dare Not Rule. Gu Jinhao agreed, and if he could gamble his life, he probably wouldn't dare to deceive him. Reluctantly sending a maid to inform Shen Nanfang of the Shen mansion, she only said that her daughter was deeply loved by Empress Dowager Xian, so she stayed in the palace for one night. Shen Nanfang began to think that the unfilial daughter had caused some trouble again. After hearing the message, he finally calmed down and added incense to his deceased wife, thanking her for her protection. The next morning, Gu Jinhao led Shen Qingshuang into the Shouan Palace. At the age of 40, Empress Dowager Xian, although her head was covered in jewels and elegant, had a sickly and haggard appearance, and her eyes were dull and lifeless. Gu Jinhao just lost his beloved yesterday. Today, seeing his mother like this, he felt a sense of sadness and his eyes were filled with pain. "My son, please see my mother." Seeing him bowing, Shen Qingshuang quickly followed and said, "My daughter, please see Empress Dowager Xian." Xian Taifei smiled pale and waved, "Jinhao, you haven't come to see this palace for a long time. Come and sit down." Gu Jinhao sat next to her and smiled, saying, "I've been busy lately. I'll be fine in a few days. I'll come and see my mother often." Consort Xian nodded and patted his hand, showing a loving expression on her face. This son is her only concern in this world. If it weren't for being unable to let go of him, she would have gone with the former emperor long ago. Seeing Shen Qingshuang kneeling there, he asked, "This little girl has seen me for the first time in this palace. Who is she?" Upon hearing her question, Shen Qingshuang quickly stepped forward and said, "Empress Dowager, my daughter is the daughter of Shen Nanfang and has some medical skills. Therefore, I would like to ask your highness to come and treat Empress Dowager." "Yes, Empress Dowager. She said she was cured well, so my son brought her over to try." Empress Dowager Xian was not hopeful and sighed, "There are so many imperial doctors in the imperial hospital who are helpless, you little girl." She didn't finish speaking, but the meaning goes without saying. Shen Qingshuang didn't care and smiled lightly. I apologize to you, but it's not that the imperial doctors are powerless, but that they dare not treat me. As soon as these words were spoken, both Empress Dowager Xian and Gu Jinhao were taken aback. But her eyes were clear and sincere, not like lies. Empress Dowager Xian sighed slightly, held back her left and right, leaving only her personal maid Yuping. She rubbed the jade bracelet on her wrist, crystal clear, just like the little girl's thoughts. How could Shen Nanfang, a military general, know about the affairs in the palace? Shen Qingshuang knew she had misunderstood and explained, Empress Dowager, my father is a martial artist. How could he understand these things? This is my daughter's guess. A small woman can cure a disease, and the vast imperial hospital is helpless. Isn't that a joke? She walked up to Empress Dowager Xian and placed her hand on her wrist. With this gesture, she understood that the illness was consistent with what was said in the original work. Studying medicine for so many years is not just about exams. Looking for a pen and paper, Long Feifeng wrote a prescription and handed it to Gu Jinhao, saying, take the medicine. Suddenly being appointed as an envoy, Gu Jinhao had not yet entered a state, and seeing his mother eagerly watching him, he went out to call Qin Yun. Shen Qingshuang chased him out. Hero, get me another set of silver needles for acupuncture and moxibustion. Qin Yun's figure was shaken. Although he was slightly less handsome and graceful than his master, his majestic demeanor was beyond doubt as a close guard of the Grand Prince. It's really embarrassing to be shouted out by a cute girl with each hero in her mouth. The medicine is not complicated, it will be cured soon. Carrying a food box and a silver needle, Qin Yun hurried towards Shouan Palace. But I didn't expect to meet a group of glamorous women, surrounded by a very luxurious woman. Qin Yun often enters the palace and recognizes her as the Empress Dowager. He stopped, put down his food box, and respectfully bowed, I see the Empress Dowager. The Empress Dowager gave a faint glance and said, what is this? Returning to the Empress Dowager, Grandma Yuping from Shouan Palace felt unwell. His Highness asked me to go to the Imperial Hospital to collect medicine. The Empress Dowager let out a hmm and glanced at the food box again. She didn't say anything and let him go. Qin Yun breathed a sigh of relief, not realizing that he had some natural talent when telling lies. Life is short, I can't help but hesitate. Little cuties, please cast your votes for me. End of this chapter. Chapter 6. What should I do in this palace? Thank you. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Chapter 6. What should I do in this palace? Thank you. Returning to the Shouan Palace, he talked about his encounter with the Empress Dowager, and Empress Dowager Xian praised him for doing well. She also had suspicions from Shen Qingshuang, and the suspect was the Empress Dowager. Isn't that woman holding a grudge against the emperor for spoiling her during his lifetime? Just about to take medicine, I was stopped by Gu Jinhao, but subconsciously I still don't believe someone. Shen Qingshuang couldn't help but understand his caution. He put down the silver needle and didn't waste his time. He took out a spoonful of medicine and drank it himself, saying, is that okay? Gu Jinhao was choked to the point where he couldn't speak, feeling like he was being a villain in vain. However, Empress Dowager Xian felt that this girl was straightforward and didn't ask much, so she drank directly. After a while, Gu Jinhao was invited out and left Shen Qingshuang to give injections to Empress Dowager Xian. Qin Yun, what do you think of Shen Qingshuang? Gu Jinhao turned his hand behind his back, his eyes puzzled. How is this completely different from the foolish flower fool I had in my previous impression? Qin Yun had very little contact with her before and didn't know how to answer a question at first. He scratched his head and said, I just think she's too bold. Not only bold, but also vulgar. It doesn't look like a woman, and words like, bastard, and, bastard, come out of her mouth. Did she say anything to you last night? Gu Jinhao's eyes were scrutinized. Qingyun dared not conceal it and said truthfully, "I asked if my subordinate had anything to do with you." When she found out, she was extremely happy and even said that great kindness must be rewarded. Gu Jinhao. Dot. Shouldn't she strangle her wrist and sigh? Why does it seem like you despise yourself? But which one of my tendons is wrong and I still feel a sense of loss? Next, the two of them remained silent, looking up at the white clouds in the sky, gathering and dispersing, gathering and dispersing. Jinhao, come on in. Upon hearing the cheerful voice of Empress Dowager Xian, Gu Jinhao stepped into the palace. At first glance, I was stunned. Empress Dowager Xian was radiant with a rosy face, and even pinched Shen Qingshuang's fair and tender little face, which was extremely affectionate. Gu Jinhao rubbed his eyes, he was not mistaken. Jinhao, Qingshuang is not only beautiful, gentle, and cute, but also has excellent medical skills. With just one dose of medicine and one injection, my palace feels much more relaxed. I really want to thank her well. The Empress Dowager's words are too heavy, it's my pleasure. Shen Qingshuang's raised eyebrows and light smile were completely different from last night's gas receiver. Gu Jinhao had never noticed that she smiled very well. Yes, it looks great. Has the mother consort recovered yet? No, drink the medicine 3 times a day and administer injections every 5 days. It will take half a month. As she spoke, she put away the silver needle and said, "Empress Dowager, please take the medicine on time. I will come back in 5 days. During this period, no matter who gave me the other medicine, it will all be stopped." Consort Xian readily agreed, but she couldn't bear to let her go and insisted on keeping her for lunch. She was in great fear and refused to comply. Grandma Yuping sighed and said, "The Empress Dowager has not had such a good appetite for a long time." Empress Dowager Xian looked affectionate and said, "Thanks to Qingshuang. Girl, how can I thank you in this palace?" Shen Qingshuang cast a glance at Gu Jinhao and whispered, "Madam, you don't need to thank me. But can you please ask His Highness not to make things difficult for me anymore? I'm really afraid of him." "Shen Qingshuang, what are you talking about?" Gu Jinhao glared at her fiercely, but was instead glared at by his mother. "Jinghao, pay attention to your attitude. Mother's words are here. If you dare to bully Qingshuang again, don't enter the Shouan Palace in the future." The black face god was feeling exhausted, and Shen Qingshuang felt particularly happy in his heart. After finishing his meal, he pinched the shoulders and back of the virtuous Empress Dowager, and also taught some health preservation methods to Yuping. The lifeless Shouan Palace suddenly regained vitality, like a barren land where grass grew and birds flew. After leaving Shouan Palace, Shen Qingshuang walked lightly, like a butterfly. However, the pain in his left arm was still severe, and although Qin Yun's whip didn't exert much force, it was still quite injured. Gu Jinhao caught up and said, "Your injury hasn't healed yet. Walk slowly." She turned her head and glanced at him, showing no interest in anything, either cheating or stealing. "Is the cancellation you promised still worth it?" "Hmm." She smiled and finally had no worries about her life. "Then let's clear up. I have to go home. I didn't come back all night, the old man must have thought I had caused trouble." As soon as he took 2 steps, Gu Jinhao grabbed him and pointed ahead, his eyes indifferent. "I owe you one favor to accompany me in a performance," he said. She looked up and saw Fang Mingzhu and Lady Xu walking towards this side. With a sly smile, "My relationship is not easy to repay." He gave her a white glance and actually blocked him with his words. "What about this king's promise with his own body?" She trembled coldly, so terrifying. Shaking his head like a tambourine, he said, "No need, thank you. I owe you this favor for now." End of this chapter. Chapter 7. "Miss Fang, please take care of yourself in the future." You are listening at novelfull.audio. Chapter 7. "Miss Fang, please take care of yourself in the future." Fang Mingzhu walked with Lady Xu's arm, and it was a clear and pleasant day with a pleasant breeze, making people feel relaxed and happy. As I was walking, I suddenly saw two familiar figures walking towards me, with a smile on my lips. "I have seen your highness before." Fang Mingzhu bowed with a smile. If it had been before, Gu Jinhao would have helped her up with both hands, but not today. It was just a faint sentence. "Please rise up." Fang Mingzhu was shocked and couldn't help but look at him, but his gaze fell on Shen Qingshuang, who was bowing to Lady Xu, with a smile in his eyes. Consort Xu naturally noticed something unusual and said softly, "Miss Shen, please get up. How come you have time to enter the palace today?" Before Shen Qingshuang could answer, Gu Jinhao had already taken the lead and said, "My mother wants to see Qingshuang, so I brought her to Shouan Palace." Upon hearing this Qingshuang sound, Shen Qingshuang almost couldn't spit out her lunch. "Why is the dog prince so shameless? It's just acting, just realistic. Do you have to be disgusting?" Fang Mingzhu's face had turned black, and her nails were tightly picking at her flesh. "It was only one night, how did it turn out like this? Men really change their minds. Miss Fang, have you gone to the palace again to accompany Lady Xu?" Gu Jinhao smiled faintly, thinking that going from being close to being distant would not be easy, but in reality, it was not difficult either. Fang Mingzhu forced a smile and said, "Yes, Your Highness. I wonder if Your Highness can take a step to speak." Gu Jinhao sneered inwardly, "Is she so eager? It's also good, that's what she meant. Jinhao, do you no longer like me?" Fang Mingzhu's eyes were filled with tears. If it had been before, Gu Jinhao would have felt heartbroken. Unfortunately, hearing her words last night, his heart had already cooled. He didn't answer and looked at her quietly. Sure enough, she took out a jade pendant from her sleeve, which Shen Qingshuang demanded yesterday. Qingshuang said, "You have already." He still didn't answer and looked calmly. Fang Mingzhu took out her handkerchief and wiped her eyes, choking up as she said, "I know it wasn't you who did this wrong. It was Qingshuang's trickery that succeeded. Although you betrayed our relationship, I don't blame you. In my heart, you are still the most perfect Jinghao. However, we can't be together anymore, do you understand?" Gu Jinhao's heart was calm, as if seeing a farce. Seeing that she was just crying but didn't have much tears, she smiled and said, "I understand." Fang Mingzhu's heart twitched and she said, "Do you really understand?" Gu Jinhao nodded and said, "Of course I understand. You want to marry your brother, but it's difficult for you to speak up, so we designed this king together with Qingshuang. As you wish, we can never be together again." Fang Mingzhu hesitated as if struck by lightning and said, "No, no, this is Qingshuang's strategy. Jinghao, you must believe me. Believe me." Gu Jinhao waved his hand and said, "This is the end of the matter. There's nothing to say. Last night, I heard what you said." He took the jade pendant over and threw it hard, shattering it. "The past is like this jade. Miss Fang, please take it seriously in the future." Shen Qingshuang was bored waiting, but when she heard the sound of jade shattering, a look of regret appeared in her eyes. Such a valuable thing can be thrown at any moment, it's really amazing. Looking at him again, he seemed to have some expectations. Immediately, he put on a smiling face and waved to him, "Jinhao, are you okay? You still need to go see my dad. Coming." Gu Jinhao was obviously satisfied with her performance. Ignoring Fang Mingzhu's dark face, he held her hand and left. At this moment, Fang Mingzhu was truly sad and threw herself into the arms of Lady Xu, crying loudly. "Why? It shouldn't be like this. If you want to save it, there's still time to go now," said Xufei coldly, looking down on this sister. She shook her head and cried for a while before wiping away her tears. "No, I'm the one who's going to the palace. Cousin, let's go see the emperor." End of this chapter. Chapter 8. This is what you said. Great kindness must be rewarded. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Chapter 8. This is what you said. Great kindness must be rewarded. Shen Qingshuang's hand had been held by Gu Jinhao all along, feeling extremely uncomfortable. She secretly turned around to look, and they had already walked away. Can you let go now? She was really not used to it, especially with so many people passing by. Gu Jinhao said in a muffled voice, make a complete set of plays, let's talk about it after leaving the palace. It's still a long way from leaving the palace. She became anxious and said, Big brother, can you take care of my reputation? I will become the laughing stock of the capital. Is this the only way I can embarrass you? Gu Jinhao's focus seemed to be off target, and Shen Qingshuang was too lazy to explain. Suddenly, he saw a spirited young man approaching from afar. Ignoring the pain in his arm, he quickly withdrew his hand and distanced himself from him. Yu before she could finish speaking, she looked at her nervously and smiled along with her gaze. It turned out that Shen Qingshu had arrived. Shen Qingshu, the second son of General Ding and Shen Nanfang, was the commander of the Imperial Guard. He didn't expect to meet them here, so he bowed to Gu Jinhao and said, I have seen your highness forth. Shen Tongling, please rise up. Second brother, Shen Qingshuang lowered her head and said with a sarcastic expression, what a coincidence. Shen Qingshu affectionately patted her arm and was about to ask why she didn't go home last night when she showed her teeth and said, it hurts, it hurts, it hurts. What's going on, what's going on? Shen Qingshu was even more nervous than her. Hurt. She let out a, and dared not reveal Gu Jinhao. She pointed to the hero behind her and said, Qin Yun caught a thief yesterday and whipped me. Whip how painful it should be. Qin Yun is so bold. Shen Qingshu's handsome face immediately turned black, and he gritted his teeth as he looked at Qin Yun with a bewildered expression. You dare to hurt my sister? No, it's not. Qin Yun was speechless, and before he could even think of a reason, he was slapped by Shen Qingshu and spat out a mouthful of blood on the spot. And his master clearly had an indifferent attitude, seemingly deliberately distancing himself from him. Qin Yun only felt that he was blind and had followed such a scammer. Seeing that he still had to continue, he quickly rolled over to Shen Qingshuang and said, Miss Shen, is this what you said about a great kindness and virtue being rewarded with thick rewards? Shen Qingshuang forgot about this incident and sneered, one code, hero. Now let's clear up. That thick report will definitely be reported in the future. Reward the kindness with kindness. Fourth Highness, wait for the old slave. Gu Jinhao followed the sound and saw the eunuch Zhang Degui beside the emperor. He ran all the way, the dust in his hand drifting with the wind, extremely happy. I couldn't help but frown and say, Zhang Gonggong, you are also an old man in the palace. Why are you acting so unsteadily? Zhang Degui's lips twitched, he wanted to be steady, but what's the use of being steady? This master has never seen the end, it would be great if he could block it. Your Highness, upon hearing that you have entered the palace, the Emperor has invited you to go to the Imperial Garden to admire the flowers. A pair of shrewd little eyes flickered as they looked at the woman next to him, and their eyes lit up. The Emperor also said that Miss Shen will come with you. Ah! Why should I go? Shen Qingshuang immediately shrank behind her brother. The water in the palace was too deep, and she was too kind and innocent, afraid. Zhang Degui cleared his throat as he saw her so resistant and said, the Emperor wants to see what kind of person Miss Shen is, and how could he make Fourth Prince infatuated. End of this chapter. Chapter 9. How I Marry You. You are listening at novelfull.audio. Chapter 9. How I Marry You. Is obsession really so obvious? The dog prince directly took her hand, causing Shen Qingshu's dog eyes to widen. He knew that Hua Qi's younger sister had impure thoughts about Gu Jinhao, but what was Gu Jinhao's mistake in holding his sister's hand? There were too many people to ask, so he temporarily suppressed his curiosity that had already spread like wildfire. "There's another play to play, just do it like before," Gu Jinhao said in a low voice. Shen Qingshuang didn't quite understand until she saw Consort Xu and Fang Mingzhu in the Imperial Garden. "It has to be said that this dog prince has quite keen insight. My younger brother, please see the emperor. My daughter, see the emperor." The emperor turned his head and smiled meaningfully, raising his hand to flatten himself. "Consort Xu told me that Miss Shen had accompanied Jin Hao into the palace, but I still don't believe it. I didn't expect it to be true. Jin Hao, when did you start with Miss Shen and why did you keep it from me?"
"Brother Hui, it just started yesterday.
Yesterday? So fast. I don't believe it." The emperor's gaze was playful, he was the emperor, not a fool. There have been rumors in the capital about his fourth brother and Fang Mingzhu, but suddenly it turned into Shen Qingshuang, and there must be some tricks involved. But Gu Jinhao clearly couldn't ask here, so he turned to Shen Qingshuang and said, "Miss Shen, really?" Shen Qingshuang felt a strong force in her hand and glared at the dog prince with hatred. Immediately, she gave a sweet smile, as pleasing to the eye as the peach blossoms in this garden. "Returning to the emperor, it was yesterday. There is a saying that goes, well, I don't know where I started, but it goes deeper. The relationship between my daughter and your highness suddenly started yesterday, and then it deepened. I just came out of the Shouan palace, and your highness is going to take my daughter to the outskirts to admire the scenery."
"Your highness, right?"
Gu Jinhao nodded very cooperatively, his eyes extremely gentle, making Shen Qingshuang nauseous. If it weren't for her overly handsome face, she probably wouldn't be able to continue acting. The emperor looked at Fang Mingzhu with jealous eyes and smiled, "But I've heard before that Jin Hao likes Miss Fang. Miss Shen doesn't mind at all." Fang Mingzhu's figure shook. At this critical moment of entering the palace, there should be no chaos. She was extremely nervous and twisted her handkerchief in her hand.
"Your Majesty, my daughter and your highness are innocent."
Xu Fei pulled Fang Mingzhu and didn't ask her what she was hitting at the muzzle of the gun. Shen Qingshuang cleared her eyes for a second and switched to indifferent Gu Jinhao, smiling.
"Your Majesty, if you like this kind of thing, there's no need to take it too seriously in the eyes of my daughter. Look at the peach trees in this garden, they are here every day and year. But this year's flower lovers will be different from last year's, let alone the elusive emotions. Last year, they were still in this sect, with peach blossoms shining red. People's faces are nowhere to be seen, but peach blossoms still smile in the spring breeze. As long as your highness's heart is filled with a servant girl at this moment, she will be satisfied. As for the next moment, love who?" The emperor was amazed by her words, loving everyone. Gu Jinhao's face was very awkward. What was he? The emperor smiled slightly and said, "If you two love each other well, how about I marry you?" This sentence was like a bolt from the blue. Everyone present was shocked, especially Shen Qingshuang. She was just playing as a friend and couldn't spend her whole life on it. She quickly knelt down and said, "Your Majesty, no way. No way." The emperor snorted lightly. "If you don't have a legitimate reason, I can treat you as disobedient. To resist orders, but to be beheaded." Shen Qingshuang almost cried. Legitimate, where should she go to find a legitimate reason? In a moment of anxiety, he looked at the dog prince for help, but he stood still and remained silent. Did he become mute? "Brother, brother, can only ask for help from my own brother."
Shen Qingshu was originally happy for his sister, but finally he was able to fulfill his wish. Seeing the fear in her eyes, she realized that she really didn't want to marry. She had no time to think about the reason behind it, so she immediately knelt down and said, "Your Majesty, my mother has just passed away for less than half a year. My younger sister must be filial for 3 years and dare not follow orders." End of this chapter. Chapter 10. Maybe everything is not as good as people. You are listening at novelfull.audio.
Chapter 10. Maybe everything is not as good as people being filial for 3 years is really a good reason. If it weren't for the emperor in front of her, Shen Qingshuang would have wanted to get up and applaud her brother. Whether it's my dear brother or not depends on whether I can handle things at critical moments. It is obvious that Shen Qingshu is close. Upon receiving the affirmation from his younger sister, Shen Qingshu nodded solemnly, as if saying, "If you get married, I ask myself that I can't do anything about it. If you can't get married, it's a piece of cake." Sure enough, the emperor was moved by the words and raised his hand to make her lie flat. Filial piety comes first, and it is rare for Miss Shen to be so filial. In this situation, if there were not a few tears, it would be somewhat damaging. Shen Qingshuang silently reached out and pulled into her sleeve. Surprisingly, she didn't have any props and didn't wear a handkerchief. However, it didn't delay either. I lifted my sleeve and rubbed my eyes hard, then pinched my arm a few times. My eyes turned red and tears streamed down my face. The emperor's praise is absurd. This is the filial piety that one should fulfill as a child. With a mother, there is still a place to come in life; without a mother, there is only a way back in life. My daughter passed away before she could repay her mother's kindness in raising her child. She must wait until the end of her filial piety period before considering her future. Sincere words, accompanied by tears on his face, made Shen Qingshu unable to help but miss his deceased mother. Seeing the emperor's lips twitching slightly, she was afraid of another decree and said, "To be honest with the emperor, even after 3 years of filial piety, my daughter has no plans to get married." "Oh. Why is this? There's no girl in the family who can't get married. Aren't you and Jean Hao in love?" the emperor asked with a curious look in his eyes. Gu Jinhao cleared his throat and looked at her playfully, full of threats. Shen Qingshuang took the opportunity to wipe away her tears and gave the dog prince a white glance. When she took off her sleeve, she began to choke again. "Your Majesty, my daughter and your highness naturally like each other, but for my daughter, the best love is not eternal, but once possessed. What I want to do is a cinnabar mole on your highness's heart, not the mosquito blood on the wall. The ultimate goal of mutual love is to know each other, never to look at each other or dislike each other." After speaking passionately, she smiled slightly and then took the hand of the dog prince, saying affectionately, "Your highness, is that what you think?" Gu Jinhao's hand was suddenly held by her, and when she spoke so gently, her heart beat so fast that she forgot to answer. Shen Qingshuang, however, thought that the dog prince was intentionally making fun of her and immediately became furious. "Help me create a white-eyed wolf." With his body slightly tilted to one side, blocking the emperor's line of sight, he lowered his voice and said, "I just owe you a favor now. Tell me quickly, otherwise it will scatter twice with one slap." Gu Jinhao regained his senses and talked so much nonsense. "Now is the key. Although inexplicably angry in my heart, it is ultimately a contradiction within the people." With a smile on his face, he said, "Brother, I also think so. Enjoy the present for now, the future is still long, take it slow." "Yes, yes, there's plenty of time anyway." The emperor was originally on the rise and no longer persisted, but he dared not agree with their views on love. "After all, you are too young, just like a child. However, if in a few years you two still haven't met the person you want to get married, I will grant you another marriage without delay." Shen Qingshuang smiled awkwardly yet politely, hoping to quickly turn over the article. Zhang Degui came and went, shaking the emperor dizzy. "Why is it so unstable? Did you vent your anger on him?" Zhang Degui's mouth twitched, and in just half an hour, he was scolded for being unstable for the second time. "He wants to be steady, isn't there something on his mind?" "Your Majesty, the Empress Dowager has sent someone to urge you," he said cautiously. The emperor then realized that he had arranged an appointment with the Empress Dowager and glanced at Lady Xu and Fang Mingzhu, saying, "Let's go." Fang Mingzhu quickly straightened her hair and clothes, and helped Lady Xu follow with dignity. As he passed by Gu Jinhao's side, his footsteps stopped for a moment and he didn't look at him, causing a wave of disappointment. Yu Guang caught a glimpse of Lady Xu's reproachful gaze, blushed, and walked forward with her head down. Gu Jinhao quickly caught up with Shen Qingshuang, and when he saw her smiling, he suddenly had a black line on his head. "Say, why did you laugh so lewdly just now? Obscure. Are you talking about her?" Shen Qingshuang became unconvinced and said, "Your Highness, as long as you're not blind, you can see the sincerity, brightness, and natural cuteness of my daughter's smile. I don't know where to start with this lewdness." Qin Yin whispered, "Miss Shen, your Highness is right. It's obscene." Shen Qingshuang said, "What's lewd?" "It's embarrassing for me. With so much talk, it seems like I just hit lightly." Gu Jinhao snorted, "What are you embarrassed about? I wonder if your Highness would like to hear a poem that caters to the occasion." Her cunning gaze made Gu Jinhao feel that he didn't hold back any good words, but if he didn't let her speak, it would make him appear stingy. With his hand behind his back and an indifferent expression on his face, he said, "Speak up. I haven't become famous yet, but I haven't married yet. Maybe I'm not as good as others." As soon as he finished speaking, he grabbed Shen Qingshu and ran away, leaving behind Gu Jinhao, who was furious and clenched his fist, his eyes about to burst into flames. "Everything may not be as good as people. He is the fourth prince of the Qi dynasty, with a majestic and handsome appearance, not as good as a person. Who is inferior to others? This dead girl is getting more and more reckless." Looking at his uncontrollable anger, Qin Yin weakly said, "Your Highness, you can't beat her anymore. I only whipped her once, and before I exerted force, she was beaten internally by her second brother. She still has two brothers, so I won't give up easily. I'm a bit scared." Gu Jinhao glanced at him and snorted, "You take it for yourself. You can even hit a little girl so hard, isn't you a man? Your arms are bleeding, how can you bear it? Qin Yun. Dot. How blind is he to be with such a picky boss?" Shen Qingshu rested today and only entered the palace to find his sister. "I originally wanted to take her home directly, but he was full of questions and didn't feel at ease without asking clearly. After all, we still have to collude to confess, right?" The brother and sister entered a tea house and ordered some small dim sum. Shen Qingshuang drank tea slowly and enjoyed the scenery, completely ignoring her brother's curious eyes. Shen Qingshu also dared not urge, based on past experience, the more he urged, the less he could ask. After two cups of tea, the ancestor finally spoke up. "Second brother, please treat me to this meal. I don't have any money." Shen Qingshu almost spat out a mouthful of old blood. When did she ever make this pishio pay? "Moreover, it is not necessary here at all." Yu Yu said, "You forgot. This Chui Soul Tower is opened by Xiao San. We can come here to give him face. How dare we take money to kill him?" Xiao San is Shen Qingshuang's third brother, Shen Qingyan. The book mentions that although the guy has great martial arts talent, he is so focused on money that no one knows how many shops he has opened, how much business he has done, and how much money he has earned. "I only know that if I have nothing to do, I will give Shen Qingshuang a silver ticket, afraid of hurting her." Shen Nanfang once asked the three young boys why they are enthusiastic about making money, using their lives to make money. "Is it because monthly routines are not enough?" The goods looked up at the sky, lowered their heads to look at their father, and said earnestly, "Be prepared for danger in times of peace. Be prepared for any danger. My son earns money for nothing else, just in case the general's mansion angers the holy emperor and his family is about to be robbed, there will be plenty of silver to spend. After all, he has taken everything." For having such a visionary and responsible son, Shen Nanfang doesn't know whether to be grateful to the heavens or lament the misfortune of his family. Shen Qingshu doesn't remember how his father answered, he only remembers that the mistress was beaten up and lay in bed groaning, unable to come back for a whole month. Baby, those who have tickets will hold a ticket court, while those who don't have tickets will hold a personal court. Thank you. End of this chapter.